CCX Sports presents High School Gymnastics. Tonight, a late conference meet between the Wayzata Trojans and the Hopkins Royals. From Wayzata High School in Plymouth, John Jacobson along with Debbie Rasmussen. And Debbie, we're getting late in the regular season now. 3 weeks from now, these teams will be competing in section competition.
You know, in these last couple meets that they have are really crucial. This is where you want to make sure that your consistency levels are just up to par. You want every stuck landing that you can have. They're not really going to be introducing any of the new tricks that they've been working on. Hopefully they're all ready to go with new tricks, harder tricks. This is polish time. This is when it really counts, the number of routines that you get to do in the gym during practice. Bring them out here to the meet tonight.
Wayzata has been over 141 as their top score this year. They're averaging over 139 on the year. For Hopkins, their high score is 137, but they've been in 130s all season, and that is a high mark for them in the 6 years that Megan Johnson and her sister Emily have been coaching the team. So they're very excited about this year, and they've got more girls out, a dozen more girls out for the team, in from club gymnastics, and just an exciting time to be part of Hopkins Gymnastics, which is great to see.
It is really fun to see, and they were, you know, mentioning with the coaches earlier, the club girls, it takes a while for them to acclimate from club gymnastics back, you know, over to a high school gymnastics. Scoring systems are a little bit different. Combinations you need are a little bit different, but it sounds like they are having a lot of fun this year with a really young team, and they're very excited for the future for Hopkins Gymnastics.
Should be a good meet tonight. We're going to take a break. We'll be back with our first rotation, the Hopkins Varsity up on the bars when we start our gymnastics meet here on CCX in just a moment.
Most of my family, they never graduated high school or even let alone go to college, so I'm trying to break that barrier. Every day after work, went straight to school, studied hard, and it paid off. I could not have done it alone. I see the future is really bright for me. The high school diploma is just added to the confidence, and now I feel unstoppable.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
John Jacobson, Deb Rasmussen, we are at Wayzata High School, and we are underway with the bars. This is Claire Hennen of Hopkins, our first gymnast of the night.
Excellent. Claire struggled with these a little bit in warm-up, so it's very fun that she was able to little stall on the top of the high bar on those giants, but she fought for it, and she was able to make the trick count, and she didn't have a fall. You'll see here she starts out with a glide kip, back hip circle, actually a free back hip circle. A little tiny tap there, might be a small deduction. She goes to long hang kip. Here's this big cast, and you'll see her just kind of get hung up on that top, and she is fighting to stay. That's a lot of strength for her to hold on to that trick, and then a nice, really pretty tuck flyaway dismount.
Claire is a freshman. We'll see her also on the beam tonight. Bella Hurt is up next. All-rounder, top score this year on the bars, 8.25. They wait for the score for Claire Hennen.
It was a nice start for Hopkins. There'll be the deduction for the stall on the top of the bar, but she was able to hang on to that, so she didn't fall, and she did complete the trick. So she'll get full credit for that.
She scored a 7.2. Here's Bella.
Beautiful form on these glide kips. She does two glide kips, back hip circle into the squat on. Nice long hang kip. And her giant swings. And is able to hang on to that one too. And does a nice flyaway dismount. She has that stuck landing, which is great. Shoulders are a little bit low on that. She didn't take a step though, and you'll see here, she has beautiful form. Legs are straight, toes are pointed. Each move is connected. There's no stop or pause. And here's that big cast. She's up on the top. And this one, you'll see she just stalls out a little bit. But boy, what great form on that. And here you'll see no steps on the landing. Just the shoulders are down a little tiny bit.
Well done by Bella Hurt. Abby Scabron awaiting her turn. Let's look at Megan Johnson. She is in her sixth year as head coach, coaches the team with her sister Emily, and so they've really enjoyed this season especially, and seeing the development of some of the girls who are returning to varsity and some of the new girls, and incorporating more athletes into their gymnasium. It's just been a fun year for them, relatively injury-free at this point of the season, which is kind of unusual as well. 7.95 score for Bella Hurt, and now here's Abby Skadron.
And Abby's starting out, showing us a change of direction. She does a switch kip there, which is a requirement for if you want to get all requirements underway. She's doing some rear uprise work here. She casts two rear uprises into long hand kip and a beautiful tuck flyaway dismount. Just the tiniest of step on that landing. What makes this routine so fun to watch is just the way it flows. One trick flows right into the other. Here's that switch kip, which shows that change of direction. She does the back hip circle right into the squat on. These moves are called rear uprise. You'll see she goes one right into the next, brings that into a back hip circle, casts, long hang kip. Just the tiniest step on that landing. I think it's really fun as a coach when, you know, you show up that first day and, oh my gosh, I've got a dozen new girls signed up for my team, and they just really seem to enjoy themselves. I think the two sister coaches are great mentors for these girls, and the team just really seems to have a lot of fun out there.
Kaya Pratt is up next. See, awaiting her turn as we hold on for the score here for Abby Skadron.
It's a very noisy gym, but boy, it's nice for us to come to a gym at Wayzata, the new Wayzata High School. In the past, we've been to one of the middle schools, and it's just a little bit more difficult. This is a beautiful facility.
8.125 for Abby Skadron. That's a season high for her. And now here's Kaya Pratt.
Kaya has, again, just phenomenal form. Toes are always pointed, legs are together. One move goes straight into the next. You can't do a layout flyaway any better than that. She might not have had the big giant swings that we've seen, but her form is what makes this routine beautiful to watch. And also one trick goes right into the next. Here's that free back hip circle, long hang kip cast. This was just pretty. There's no other word. It was just pretty. It floated down. Very nice.
Freshman Kay Murphy will be next. She's been their top all-arounder this year, and top all-around score of 36.25 this season. Her high on the bars has been 9.075. Certainly has helped Hopkins team score and get a 36 all-arounder. That's gonna help.
That's a big score. So yeah, and I know. She's from a private club, and getting her to acclimate to the different rules and things here, I guess she's done just an excellent job on that.
Kaya Pratt, also a season high for her on the bars, 8.3.
She ends up trying to do, unfortunately here, beautiful attempt. She was going to do a cast handstand pirouette. She did it a couple times, wasn't able to quite make that. Here's her version of Giants on the high bar. Gorgeous, perfectly straight arms. Nice job. Unfortunately, missed that handstand pirouette on the low bar, but it's, you know, you'll see here. So she does a kip cut catch, which is a release move. And as she turns her hand there, you tell she's going to do a pirouette, and she's just not on top of that bar enough. Her shoulders are just a little bit off. So talk about a seasoned gymnast. She switches that into a switch kip and continues on.
You have to kind of improvise sometimes, right?
Exactly. And here, these Giants are wonderful, and they're looking for straight body, straight arms, and then this flyaway dismount is just, again, I love how she floats and she lands with her arms over her head on that landing. So unfortunately, she'll have a small deduction for the miss of the handstand pirouette on the low bar, but still, it was a great routine.
We'll hang on for the score for Kay Murphy, and then we'll go to break as Wyzetta will be up next on the vault. And a score of 8.375 for Kay Murphy. So we'll take time out. We'll come back. More gymnastics from Wyzetta High School after this timeout.
They said a bottle was just a bottle. That no one would ever notice me. But I knew I could be more. That one day, I would make people smile.
We are back. Wyzetta Varsity up on the vault. Their first event tonight. Jada Wilson starting it off.
Starting out with a very nice half-on, half-off vault. What we're looking for on here is basically on the pre-flight, you want that half-twist to be as clean of a half-twist as possible. Obviously, form is important. And then a nice block and the half-twist afterwards. You can tell she has great form in the distance from the vaulting platform to the landing pad is really, really important too. Very strong vaulter.
The second vault.
Oh, tried to do a half on, full off, unfortunately, had that fall on the landing. That is the half a point deduction, and then there's a small deduction for not finishing it. But you could tell she just about had it almost over rotated, like she couldn't added another half a twist on there. Sometimes when gymnasts are so strong, it's kind of hard to stop that rotation when that momentum's going.
Her first vault, which scored an 8.4, likely will be the highest of the two scoring vaults. Kata Molson is next for the Trojans.
Starting with a nice handspring full twist. Great form on this. What we're looking on here, again, she has beautiful form. You want to make sure that you complete that entire twist before your feet hit the landing pad. She was a little bit short on that, but the distance that she flies off this vault is pretty impressive. She's just going to need to try to finish that twist a little bit faster before she lands.
Tatum's high score in this event has been an 8.7.
This is always a tough vault when you're doing a full twist. It's a blind landing. So a lot of it, you just kind of have to go by how it feels. So she's going to block there much better. She still had that big step on the landing, but she's able to finish that full. And I'm just impressed with how far she flies. She's not a very tall girl, so she's got a lot of strength and great block on that vaulting platform to get that vault to carry as far as it does.
And an 8.8, so 3/10 of a point higher for Tatum on her second vault, as well as a season high score for her, and now Izzy Trainer.
Does a nice half on, half off. Great form. Just kind of over rotates that, so she has to take that big step on the landing. Her feet just kind of got underneath her a little bit. So What she's going to want to do is just kind of block. If she does this, or maybe she's going to throw a full twist on the second one, she just wants to block a little harder and almost wait for that half twist so she can get that to travel a little bit more without landing so short. The form was great.
8.225. And Izzy's first fault, and here's ball two.
There, nice. A little bit more in control. Step was a little bit smaller, but the form is what really makes that vault impressive. You'll see here the first twist on, and then locks those legs together and just has that step on the landing.
Lauren Osterberg will be up next for the Trojans. Score of 8.4. Izzy Trainer's second vault, giving her another 1,500ths of a point.
You know, she's getting ready to go. Perfect.
There's Lauren Osterberg's first vault. Good speed on her run.
Wow, she does a Sukahari, which is beautiful. So much power that she just totally over-rotates that. You'll see here, great block. That backflip, she just over-rotates, feet get underneath her. Sometimes it's hard to find that happy medium when you are such a strong vaulter and you can almost have too much energy. And so this one, she's gonna wanna just slow that backflip down a little bit and then try not to over-rotate it, but still, very nice vault.
Still scored an 8.6. Get one more shot at it here.
Kind of the same thing. I mean, it's a beautiful vault up until the landing, and it's just trying to find that medium where possibly she just can get those feet just behind her a little bit. It's so often we have gymnasts that land short and they don't get the back flip all the way around. In her case, she almost could pike that vault or lay that vault out with the amount of speed and power that she has.
Scored an 8.7, so she did get another tenth of a point. Madeline Tapper, she is the only senior recognized tonight on senior night, and the captain. A very good vaulter.
Does a pike Sukahari, which is really great. Good distance. Shoulders are a little bit low on that landing. She's going to want to get a little bit more height on that. But in the pike position, it has a greater starting value. And nice job for her. We need to combine the two.
She's been walking all the way back since was wondering if she's going to pass on the second ball, but now it looks like she will come back. We do see that sometimes where
yes.
The vault, if they're happy with the score. And
especially this late in the season, if there's any kind of little tweak in the ankle, you certainly don't want to jeopardize the gymnast for the rest of the 3 weeks that are remaining, because you need her at the end of the year.
She had a 9.2 for her first vault.
Beautiful. Again, just a nice vault. Smaller step on that one. When we do the Sukaharis or the Yurchenkos, you can do them in a tuck position, a pike position, and a laid out position. So we saw the tuck position, and then that vault we saw the pike position. You know, we're watching this different format where the varsity and JV are kind of competing as one team. We saw, well, Hopkins is on bars, Wyzetta is on vault. The JV team goes, then the varsity team goes. And I think we don't see it that often. I think it's a really neat way to compete because they are a team during practice. They practice together. So how fun they get to really be cheering, the varsity girls are cheering when the JV team goes and vice versa. And I kind of like this rotation. I think we should,
Madeline
more schools
Tapper
should do it.
With a 9.275.
Good score.
Top score for Wayzata on the ball. We'll take a break. Hopkins up on the vault in a moment. More gymnastics from Wayzata High School after this.
The color in my garden keeps the pink of my cheeks. I was very independent and thought I could take care of myself. I fell and I had to have Meals on Wheels. They're my savior. My name is Lola Silvestri. America, let's do lunch.
Drop off a hot meal and say hello. Volunteer by donating your lunch break at americaletsdolunch.org.
We are back at Wayzata. We're getting ready for Hopkins Varsity to compete here on the vault. Emily Feinberg will start out the rotation.
Lily starting with the half on, full off. Nice vault. Just a little bit short on that rotation. We'll see here. She's great form and just almost makes that full. Still, this vault should score pretty high. You know, this is a good opportunity. You'll see the teal ribbons that the gymnasts are wearing. In fact, all of them are wearing them tonight, the Hopkins girls and the Wayzata girls. And that is to show their support for what's kind of been going on in the news with the sexual assault amongst the Olympic gymnasts. And I just think we look at gymnastics as such a great sport, and it's a small community, and everybody has jumped on board to show these young ladies and other people that are involved in possible assault situations, we support you, we're behind you. And tonight these girls are sporting teal ribbons in their hair, which I think is really neat.
Lily Feinberg at an 8.3 and then an 8.0 for her two vaults. Riley O'Neill is up next.
Beautiful half on, half off. That just has a very nice landing. The form is great, the block is great, and the distance is also good too. You'll see she does a nice crisp twist on. Legs are nice straight together. Just a small step on that landing.
.5 for her first vault, and vault two for Riley.
Nice, that was beautiful. The form on the pre-flight and the after-flight was perfect, and even a smaller step on that landing. You'll see her, as soon as she hits that board, her legs are together, there's not a bend, they're nice and straight. Great form on that.
And Pratt is up next. .6 for Riley's second vault.
Doing a handspring full. Nice form, good distance on that. See here, she does that handspring. Makes that twist all the way around, just a step on that landing. We talk about landing so much in gymnastics, and they call it a stick landing when there are no steps, and that means there's no deductions on those. Sometimes that's what a first and second place comes down to in competition, be it here, collegiate, or in the Olympics, it's that stuck landing.
Of 8.575. One more vault for Kaya.
Again, a nice job. A little bit smaller of a step on that. First vault had the finish of the twist, but the second vault had a better landing on that. You see just a small, little small step on that landing.
Okay, Murphy up next. .855 for Kaya Pratt.
Does a handspring full also. She has great form on this nice block you'll see here. Completes that twist. Tiny, tiny, tiny hop on that landing. That should get a pretty good score. She's got great form.
One more vault coming for Kay Murphy. First vault scores an 8.725, which is a season high for the freshman.
Beautiful second vault. She landed that vault standing up a little bit more, but did take a bigger hop. I think that was a cleaner vault because you'll see the twist is good. Body position's great. There's no pike in the hip, but she does have that hop on the end. But I thought that was a beautiful vault for her.
Kayton Price is the fifth and final Hopkins gymnast. This is her only varsity event. She competes in the other one. This is the only one she competes in varsity-wise. She had her high score this year in this event, 8.725.
Beautiful. She does the handspring full as well and just nails the landing. You'll see here, she is strong. You see that nice twist, not a step on the landing. She is a, for in the world of gymnastics, she is a tall gymnast, but she makes it look so effortless. It makes it really, really pretty to watch.
And she scores an 8.95, a season high for her.
Great vault.
Kay Murphy had just gotten her season high at 8.8, so good strong vaulting performances here by the Royals tonight.
That was another, her second vault was another strong vault. Didn't get the distance on the backside of the platform, but again, just a solid landing. I love to see that.
Hold on for a moment for Kayton's score on that second vault. 8.65, so the first one, the 8.95, is the one that will go in the books and the season high for her and for Hopkins on the vault. We'll take a break. Wayzata's varsity up on the uneven bars next. More Lake Conference Gymnastics on CCX after this.
I adopted Bento in 2010 from a shelter. As it turns out, we have very similar personalities. And this cat makes me make art because he's always motivating me to take pictures of him, to draw pictures of him. He just is motivating artistically. It's just that simple. Well, he's my best friend, but a lot of people know him as Keyboard Cat.
Underway, Wayzata bars. Tatum Bolson up first on the unevens for the Trojans.
Just in watching warm-ups, the Wayzata bars is strong because they're so, their form is so good, and I think that's something that we take for granted how hard it is to actually have good form while doing a bar routine. You'll see here she does beautiful kip series. Free hip, switch kip, which shows that change of direction, squat on. Long hang kip, again, another free hip into long hang kip. Beautiful layout flyaway. Couple of little itty bitty steps on the landing. This is an event, too, where strength is so important. You've got your more of your artistic events, which are beam and floor, and then you've got your strength events, which I believe are vault and bars. Back in my day, which was 50 years ago, bars not very good at it. Didn't have a lot of upper body strength. So people that are good at bars just amaze me.
Izzy Trainer is up next for you for the Trojans.
Just impressed with their opening kip series, switch kip.
8.1 score for Tatum Bolson.
Wow, nailed the landing. Straight body, arms are already over her head, didn't have a step. And again, we talk about that form, and it's just one move, goes straight into the next. The kip back hip, switch kip, squat on. Free hip back hip circle right into that long hang kip cast, and this, beautiful.
Let's look at Carly Holden. She is in her sixth year as head coach at Wayzata. We'll see Grace Trainer here in a few moments. She's their lone state qualifier from last year. Really in a tough section now that they moved into Section 5 AA, although they have a score that's certainly decent. Will it be enough to beat Maple Grove this year is kind of the one question. So they may not get there as a team, but certainly have some individuals that could definitely qualify again and at least give Maple Grove a run. 8.0 for Izzy Trainer, so they'll get Madeline Tamper.
Just a great start. I haven't seen a drop kip in I don't know how many years, which qualifies as a release move. And again, just beautiful bar work. And she had great form. You'll see here, right here, that's a drop kip. You can't really tell, but the distance between the high and low bar is huge. It's almost a body length. But you'll see here again, just this move flows into that. She's got straight arms, straight legs, nice cast. Free hip into that beautiful long hang kip. Layout flyaway, and not even a step.
Marta Osterberg up next for the Trojans.
Here's a good, you can see from that view how far apart those bars are. So when you're dropping from the high bar to the low bar, it's quite a distance. I have to mention Wayzata's other coach. Her name is Abby Christensen, and she was a former gymnast at Wayzata, a very successful one. Then went on to have a, down at Iowa State, was a diver, and just happened to graduate with one of my kids, so I think it's...
Yeah, really good high school athletes in both sports.
In both sports,
diving,
yep.
And gymnastics.
Yep. And it's just always fun to...
There's
you know,
Abby.
Yep, there she is.
There she is.
We talk a lot about when the former gymnast comes back to their school and helps out. Your love of the school and your love of the sport, and I think they're great role models for the girls. But she's really good, too.
Our first judges conference of the night. That's the reason for the break here before Lauren Osterberg goes, as the judges confer. And now they seem to have come to an agreement on a score or a range of score for Madeline Tamper.
We usually have that when there is greater than a 5/10 difference between the two.
8.25 for Madeline Tamper.
She is a powerhouse. She was on vault. She is on bars as well. Here are her giant swings. Beautiful. Makes it up to the top. Layout, flyaway, dismount. Perfect landing. You could tell she was fighting for those giants. She was going to make those happen. She's doing kips with, we call that in the pike position, with straight legs, and it's just harder. And even her squat on is with straight legs. So that just makes the routine a little bit more, I guess, pretty is the only word I can come up with right there. You'll see her giants, beautiful at the top. First one had a little bit of a stall, but she was able to hang on to that, and just a great flyaway dismount. Nailed the landing.
our final gymnast, one of the best this season in the state on the uneven bars, Grace Traynor, two-time state qualifier. 9.65 is her high score on the bars this year.
She's going to show us a dismount that we don't see a lot of in high school competition if she throws it. I know they kept her off the vault tonight because she is dealing with just a small little tweak, and I believe it was her ankle. But if she throws the double back flyaway, it is pretty impressive.
Judges conferring again, this time on Lauren Osterberg's routine and score.
We don't usually see the judges' conference on the bars. I mean, beam and floor, we kind of, you know, get them a little bit more, but we don't really see much of them on the bars.
Our judges tonight, Jacinta Wirth to your left there, Lindsay Lahr to the right. Kelly Schwartz is the other judge for tonight's meet. Reminder, section meets coming up in 3 weeks for Wayzata. They're part of Section 5AA. It's Thursday, February 15th, 5:30 p.m. at Irondale High School. And then Hopkins, part of Section 6AA at Minnetonka High School, Saturday, February 17th at 12 noon.
Which section is Champlin in now?
Champlin Park is in Section 5AA.
So
you got Champlin Park, Hopkins, Maple Grove, Wayzata, all in that section.
Mm-hmm.
Park Center, one of the other local teams, and Hopkins in Section 6AA with Eden Prairie, Minnetonka, and some of those schools. So now here's a look at Grace Traynor finishing things off here for Wayzata on the bars.
Doing giants in the opposite direction, and then beautiful release move. Great form on that. Getting ready for, hopefully she's got, look at that. Wow, that was absolutely gorgeous. Very rare that you see a gymnast do a giant in the direction that she first started it. And then with the release move where she shoots over the top of the bar, you'll see here, casts into that giant. And as she comes down, she's going to do a half twist over to the low bar. Legs are locked. She is not giving up any of the points that she doesn't have to. And this double back flyaway, and a beautiful solid landing on that.
Yeah, it was a great routine. Good see
routine.
How it scores for Grace Traynor. Lauren Osterberg at an 8.3. They should be in the mid-9s, I would think.
I would hope so. She had all of the requirements. She had the handstands, changes the direction, the release move, and the ever-important stuck landing.
And a score of 9.575 for Grace Traynor. Not quite a season high, but that is a very, very good score on the bar. We'll take a break. We'll come up. More gymnastics from Wayzata High School. Hopkins will be up on the floor exercise, and we continue on CCX in a moment.
Did you know kids who play outdoors have healthier lungs?
Totally.
Did you know that boys that play with dolls make better husbands?
My son has lots of dolls.
But did you know terry cloth diapers breathe better?
I did. Mm-hmm.
It's totally true.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you guys know statistically friendly kids have more friends?
Yeah. That's obvious.
Did you know most people think they're using the right car seat for their kid, but they're not?
Parents who really know it all know for sure that their child is in the right seat. Visit safercar.gov/the right seat to make sure your child is protected.
John Jacobson, Deb Rasmussen. We are back at Wayzata. There's a score through two full rotations for each team. Wayzata 69.4 points. Hopkins 67.675. As we head into the floor exercise, Hopkins up first, then we'll head to the beam for each team, and then finish with Wayzata on the floor. Hopkins tonight on the floor. Abby Scadron will lead things off. She'll be followed by Sydney Schaefer, Bella Hurt, Kaya Pratt, and Kay Murphy.
You can tell this gym is new. It's very clean.
second year for the new additions here at Wayzata. The other gyms down the hallway here that are used, you know, a lot for basketball primarily. This one dedicated for gymnastics, which is nice. We're at middle school. This school's been open, what, 22, 21 years now, the high school?
Mm-hmm.
And they, all those years up until last year, had to compete at the middle school for gymnastics.
Which always drove me a little crazy because that was a very compact little gym.
We are ready, and Abby Scadron getting ready to start things off for Hopkins.
See what she throws at us for her first tumbling pass. Round up back handspring, back layout with a half twist. Always interesting to hear the music choices that each of the gymnasts decide to choose. Right there is a beautiful handstand double pirouette right into a twisting wolf jump. Second tumbling pass punch front into forward roll into cartwheel. I haven't seen that move. It's called the Thomas Blair from a male gymnast back in the 80s. Love the originality. Final tumbling pass. Round off two back handsprings into a nice high back flip. Nice job. Ends with a big smile. So we'll see this first one here. She does a nice round out back handspring layout half twist. Slightly over rotates it, but it's a tough landing on that. This one she does beautiful high punch front dive roll into the cartwheel. And this second tumbling pass she does round off. Two back handsprings into a nice high back tuck. Good finishing position.
Sydney Schaefer will be up next. She is the lone senior on this Hopkins team. Joined the team as a seventh grader. Had never jumped gymnastics before that, Deb. And Coach Johnson says it's been one of her joys in her 6 years of coaching this team to watch her grow as a gymnast and still able to hold her varsity spots on the beam and floor with all the newcomers that they had to the team this year.
That, to me, is just amazing because you see so many of the young girls that have done gymnastics outside, and here she is. She's just done the Hopkins High School program, and they are so proud of her, and she's so fun to watch. Beautiful. Handstand, full pirouette into a full twisting jump.
Abby Scadron scored an 8.25, tying her season high. Sydney Schaefer's high score on the floor this year from 8.725.
I love the fact that she's doing the routine with a smile on her face. Beautiful twisting jump combination. Front handspring dive roll cartwheel. And our final tumbling pass. Round up two back handsprings into a step out. That was a cute routine. It will be a tough night on that senior night, or yeah, her last meet, just because she's come so far with the with these coaches. So there's her round off, two back handsprings, back flip is the first tumbling pass. And she does a front handspring here into dive roll, walks out of that into a nice cartwheel. And finally round off, two back handsprings, and she walks out of that last one. And just a fun smile. She's a fun gymnast to watch.
Bella Hurt will be up next. Sydney Schaefer awaits her score.
Beam and floor are the toughest when you are standing there waiting, waiting, waiting for the judge to give you the go-ahead. The beam is worse than the floor.
Right, because you have so many nerves already, right?
Yeah.
Worrying about falling off.
This is a long wait. I can't tell if they're having a judges conference or not. Or looks, here we go. Now we're getting some scores. In the background, we got the JV Wayzata girls team on the balance beam, and they're having some fun over there.
8.35 the score for Sydney Schaefer, and here is Bella Hurt.
Love the form on that, and here's her. So she does a double handstand pirouette into a full twisting wolf drop. Nice combination. Round up back handspring, full twist to open up the first tumbling pass. In the corner, she sets up for the second tumbling pass, which usually is in the forward tumbling motion here. Gorgeous front handspring layout. Closes with round up, two back handsprings, and a back flip. Great height on that.
Bella Hurt.
Very
nicely
nice
done.
Routine. Her first pass, she opens is with the round off. Full twist. Nice job. Shoulders a little bit low on that landing, but still, it's always good to do your opening tumbling pass with twisting motion. Front handspring layout front. And then finally, love the height on this last tumbling pass. Round up, two back handspring, back flip.
Fourth gymnast coming up for Hopkins is Kaya Pratt.
It's a good chance to look at that Floor X mat that's out there. You have to stay within the bounds of the blue. If you step onto the white, you will get a deduction. That's a tenth for every foot that goes out. And the floor is actually a big square. It's 40 by 40. There are little tiny springs underneath it that kind of, as the sport has evolved and it's gotten more difficult, the equipment have adapted to the more difficulty of the sport and just allows the gymnast to throw bigger, better, stronger tricks.
Now, when you competed, was it any kind of board like that, or was it more just like a mat?
It was a wrestling mat.
Yeah, that's what I remembered.
With the wrestlers.
Yeah.
There were no springs. There was no gushy.
Bella Hurt scores an 8.35. Here's Kaya Pratt, one of the all-arounders. Her high score this year in this event has been an 8.95.
She would love to break into the nines on a floor routine. Handstand double pirouette, Notice the pointed toe. I don't think her foot leaves that floor, and it's not pointed. It's beautiful. Two back handspring into that layout, half twist. Nice leap jump sequence, adds twisting to that. Nice handspring layout front. Beautiful originality there, just showing that change of direction. I love that side shoulder roll. Pound off two back handsprings. Nice height on that last pass. Cute routine, but what made that so special was the form. The toe point. Every time the foot comes off the ground, that toe is pointed. That was a gorgeous half twist. Nice landing on that. Here's your forward sequence. Handspring layout front. And then finally the back handsprings into the back flip. She's a very technical tumble. You can see just the way she sets the back flip. She has great extension, which allows her to have a lot of height on those tumbling passes.
You think about how much work has gone into that, and being so precise mm-hmm. and making, you know, pass after pass in practice and through the years and being able to execute that.
And every year you come up with new music, new routine, new choreography. But now it's all about being consistent. You want to make sure that you are landing, finishing all your tricks, and landing all the skills that you have.
Aya Pratt scores an 8.80, and now it's Kay Murphy.
It's a 1.5 twisting wolf jump there. Beautiful. First tumbling pass, round up by handspring, full twist. She like barely ran into that first pass. Twisting jump combination. I love that little originality move there. Does that full twisting layout front there. Just a little short on that landing, but she did not fall on that. Lots of originality in the choreography of this routine. It's super fun. Third tumbling pass, which is very rare. You see a gymnast do two forward tumbling passes. They're usually more difficult, but she does two in a row and plus ends with, here's that first one. She has round up back handspring, full twist. In the second one, you'll see she does a punch layout front with a full, a little bit short, but she didn't sit it down, so I think she'll get full credit. And the last tumbling pass is sometimes what people open with. That was beautiful. Layout front into punch front.
I agree with the choreography of the fun routine.
It's cute. Yeah.
Hold on for a moment to get Kay Murphy's score before we head to break. Wayzata's beam will be up next here in our meet. Kay Murphy has scored as high as 9.3 this year on the floor. We'll see where this routine lands her and as she finishes up for Hopkins on the floor.
I think it should be right around there. Just she's got all the goods in her tumbling passes and her leap combinations, jump combinations, all above hip level, full extension on those split leaps.
The judges are going to confer on her score, so we will take a break. We'll come back, and I'll give you Kay Murphy's score, and then we'll have more gymnastics. Wayzata up on the beam in a moment. We continue here from Wayzata High School on CCX after this. Back and Wayzata getting ready to start on the balance beam. Our score for Kay Murphy on the floor. She was the last Hopkins gymnast to compete. 8.825.
Okay. I don't agree with that.
Deb wanted at least a another 3 to 4 tenths of a
yes.
point higher.
Wow, I'd like to know. Maybe I'll be having a judges conference after. Needless to say, it was a great routine. It was very fun.
Tatum Bolson will be up first on the beam for Wayzata, followed by Lauren Osterberg, Madeline Tapper, Izzy Trainer, and then Grace Trainer.
The balance beam is actually 4 feet off the ground and about 4 inches wide. And for the viewers out there right now, look down at your foot. It's about as wide as one of your feet. So when you see some of the tricks that these girls do, it's amazing. I think I've challenged you every year, John, to go stand on the balance beam.
Sit on the balance beam.
Sit on it. How about just walk up and put your hand on it, maybe?
Yeah, I might call it good.
The most difficult event in gymnastics, but if you're good at it, you love the balance beam. This is the apparatus, though, that consistency. You want to do as many routines in a day and practice that you can, so it just becomes second nature.
A little delay starting. Wait till both judges are in places before Tatum Bolson can start things off here for Wayzata.
Remember when we talked about the waiting game for the balance beam? Not fun.
And now we're set to go.
She has a no-handed squat and mount immediately into that wolf jump. Nice combination. Ooh. You can tell she's visibly a little shaken. That's always hard. You just don't realize how easy, as we said earlier, that beam is only 4 inches wide. And looks like a foot possibly slipped and both of her feet came out from underneath her. She landed pretty hard on the side of her thigh. You do have time to get up. You'll see here she just kind of slips, actually grabbing that beam and breaking her fall. Could have saved from a potential injury.
Tatum gets back up.
And I will tell you, it's one thing to fall off the beam, but to have a hard fall like that to get back up there, that shows a lot of guts. Nice straddle jumps there, two in a row. And she's able to finish with a nice punch front. but that's just a scary situation. It's really easily you're just off. This was a great punch front dismount into a very nice landing. Give her a lot of credit because you really, what you really want to do is just walk off and right. Done. And takes a strong gymnast to get back up there. You oftentimes see girls that fall that, you know, their shoulders off and they jump off to the side, but that was a pretty significant fall on the beam.
Lauren Osterberger will be up next.
I mean, I know they don't give points for bravery, but I think that they should. Quite understand. They yell it before she gets onto every apparatus and trying to hear what it is that they're saying.
Waiting the score for Tatum Bolson.
You know, when it's hard to be the gymnast that has to follow the person that had the fall.
It was a 7.25 for Tatum.
She did a nice opening series there, cartwheel directly into a round off. Nice twisting wolf jump. So she's getting ready for wolf jump. Nice job. She was supposed to connect the first with the second, but instead we'll connect the second with the third, and that'll work. And a nice gainer backflip dismount off the side of that.
Look again at Lauren Osterberger on the beam.
That is a great combination. You're doing a cartwheel into a round off, and the most important thing there is that one foot cannot touch. It's got to swing all the way through and go into the next skill. There's the gainer backflip off to the side in the pike position. A little step on the landing, be a little bit of a deduction there, but not too bad.
Madeline Tapper is up next.
Find that the judging the beam and the floor takes a little bit longer than the bars or vault. There's more in the routines, and there's more combinations and requirements that you have to have. It's, you know, vault, you're looking at them for maybe 5-6 seconds. On bars, maybe 15 to 30. But when you get to the floor and the balance beam, it's just a little bit more difficult. There's more meat in the routines. Gosh, and we were just saying, John, this meat was just cruising along. Now we're having
a little bit longer
judging.
Madeline Trainer up next. The score of 8.05 for Lauren Osterberg.
It's going to open up here with. Oh, put a big smile when she jumped off. There should be points for that, too. That's incredibly difficult. That is a standing backflip on the balance beam. Hill straddle jumps, adding a quarter turn to the one. The full turn, which every beam routine has to have in it. Very nice half twisting straddle jump. You'll see, hang on. Oh, darn. That was that cartwheel round off combination where that foot needs to go all the way through. Fighting to stay on for each trick. Pike front. It was a great routine. A couple of disappointments, missing the back flip and then the cartwheel combination. That is just so incredibly hard, and it doesn't take much. You know what I love is her smile. She's like, okay, dang it, next time.
And when she first landed, it looked like, oh, she's going to stick it. But you're right, it doesn't take much, does it?
No. I mean,
a little lean and you're off.
And you're off. One shoulder dips a half an inch and bam.
And the trainer sisters will be fourth and fifth here, Izzy and then Grace. Both have scored in the nines in this event this year. Tallying the score right now for Madeline Tamper. As I mentioned, their high score this year in the 141s, 141.725. Again, that'll be among the top scores in Section 5AA. Will it be enough to topple Maple Grove? They're kind of the favorite going in.
And what? And their high score has?
They've been in the 140, I want to say 144.
Okay.
Now here is Izzy Trainer. Score 7.8 for Madeline Tamper. Izzy's high score on the balance beam this year, 9.35.
Beautiful leap sequence there. Twisting split jump. Cartwheel, and again, you wanna, to get the credit for the combination, you need to swing that foot through. She didn't fall, but she'll miss that connection. That was a wonderful sequence. She does a twisting tuck jump immediately into the back flip dismount with no hesitation at all. So you'll see here, again, that foot is supposed to swing all the way through and not touch, but she didn't fall. She was able to save that. And then there is the round off. This was just really unique. Very nice twisting tuck jump right into the backflip dismount. Wonder if there's healthy competition with the two girls? Or if one has a stronger event or.
Seems like most of the time through the years, we haven't found out that it's healthy. So
I don't have it.
Well, siblings are usually pretty good rivals, especially when they're younger, I think.
My sister.
Not that these girls aren't mature enough to rise above that, but I'm saying.
Yes. My sister tried to get me to step off the side of the Grand Canyon when I was little, so.
Nice. 8.8 the score for Izzy Trainer. Now here's Grace Trainer. Grace has, again, had great scores in this event this year. Is a one of the state's top all-rounders, 9.65 is her best score.
Beautiful backhand spring sequins. Great control. Tiny little balance check at the end there, but nothing to cause a major deduction. That was a nice combination. Very, very difficult round up, full twist, back flip dismount. When you watch that dismount, you realize she actually is kind of running into that dismount. And again, we're talking about a balance beam that is literally 4 inches wide. Here's your two back handspring. What makes them so special is just the connection is just so great. And here's that round off, full twist, tiny step on that landing. I think it's hard enough to do a round-off on the floor, let alone do it on the balance beam.
That was a very difficult routine and executed pretty well, I thought, by Grace Trainer. We'll hang on for a moment and wait for her score. Hopkins JV still competing out on the floor exercise right now, and then their varsity will be up here on the beam in a few minutes. And judges are going to confer. So we'll take a timeout. We'll come back. We'll give you Grace Trainer's score. And then Hopkins will be up on the beam. More gymnastics here on CCX from Wayzata High School after this timeout. Set to go. Hopkins on the balance beam. Claire Hennon leading things off for the Royals. Claire was our first gymnast we saw tonight on the uneven bars to begin the meet.
She had a beautiful back handspring, back walkover, doing her twisting jump. Slight balance correction, but was able to stay on the beam. That full turn is so much harder than it looks, and every routine has to have that in it. It's difficult when you do your tumbling sequence and you're able to land that, and then you fall off on something like the full turn. Split leap, wolf jump. Punch front into a very nice duck landing. The fall is unfortunate because that was a really clean routine up till that point. There's the back handspring. Swings those arms all the way through into the back walkover. And then here is her punch front and just solid on that landing. The trick on the connecting of the two acrobatics is you want to make sure that your body stays in motion. So when she does the back handspring and she's setting up for the back walkover, you don't want your arms to ever slow down or stop. Then you won't get full credit for the connection. That was a little on the border. I think she'll be fine. But there was a tiny, tiny hesitation, and those connections are so important.
Sydney Schaefer will be next, followed by Lucy Spears, Kaya Pratt, and then Kay Murphy.
This probably is the most difficult event for a gymnast who has never done gymnastics. So the fact that she has hung on to her varsity spot with just starting in Hopkins Gymnastics, 7 years ago, pretty unique.
Claire Hannon scored a 7.7. Sydney Schaefer, her top score on the beam this year has been 8.4.
She does a dive cartwheel there, which we don't see that often. Two very nice wolf jump into a split jump. The dive cartwheel basically means that there is a tiny second one. Nothing's touching the balance beam. She's got air time, so to speak. Nice full twisting or three-quarter twisting wolf jump. Into a full twisting tuck jump. Setting up for the full turn. Ooh, little balance check. Hangs on to that one. That's good. Nice backflip dismount. Just a small step on the landing. She might not have the tumbling skills, but her dance elements by adding that full twisting tuck jump, connecting the other twisting jumps to that. Here's that little dive cartwheel, solid. So there's the wolf jump into the split jump, nice job. Get ready for her backflip dismount. Great height on that, just a small step back on the landing. She should be very, very happy with that one.
Lucy Spears will be up next. The first chance to see Lucy tonight, who's competed junior varsity on the vault bars and floor, but it's a varsity spot here tonight for Beam.
I think that's kind of a fun thing about this sport is you can be on JV for a couple events, you can be on varsity for a couple events. Sometimes if someone's having a bad night or there's an injury, then you go ahead and that JV girl can jump up and take a spot in varsity if need be.
.875 for Sydney Schaefer. Lucy Spears.
Just off to the side on that mount. Gets that full turn out of the way right away. Split jump into the twisting wolf jump, and your shoulders are just off. Balance beam and to the cartwheel there. Beautiful round up, nice and solid on that trick. Backflip dismount, really good landing. Very unfortunate she had the falls in there. Here's that round up, nice and solid. Getting ready for the backflip dismount. Got great height, nice solid landing. The falls were unfortunate, but what she did a good job.
We've had more than our share of falls, unfortunately, tonight on the beam between the two teams.
Yep, and you know, I guess you don't want to have those falls this late in the season, but better to have them now than when you get up into the section meets and stuff. You certainly would like to hit 5 for 5. That's each coach's goal, but it hasn't just been one team. It's been both of them that have struggled. Talk a lot about the balance beam can really make or break a team score too.
Melissa Spears, 6.75. The Silver Fall certainly hurt her. Now we look at Kaya Pratt.
Starting off solid with some jumps and leap sequence. Here she's getting ready. Job. Back handspring, back walkover. The coach stepped in. He did not touch her, so there'll be no deduction for him. She has the same beautiful toe point on the balance beam that she does on the floor exercise and the bars. Nice backflip dismount into a solid landing.
Kaya's high score has been 8.95. We'll see as we look at the routine again where this routine lands her.
Let's see, that was a great back handspring, back walk over. Tiny balance check there. Here's that backflip, and you'll just see it's nice height, great. Good landing on that. Pressure situation when you have to follow. We talked about the Wayzata gal that had to follow after that nasty fall to follow a routine that had more than one fall. So you know how important your routine now becomes to the final team score. And that's a lot of pressure too. She was warming up on the sidelines, and she's got some pretty big tricks for her routine today. We'll be seeing possibly an aerial walkover into a back handspring, which is a really, each trick on their own is difficult. And then when you combine them, it increases to the value.
Okay, Murphy, we'll have to wait to see and perform some of those tricks. She has scored as high as 9.3 as judges confer here on Kaya Pratt's score. Kay Murphy, the final varsity performer tonight for Hopkins. Last rotational feature, Wayzata's varsity up on the floor.
She's, because of her club experience, the weight for her maybe might not be as nerve-wracking. But the fact that she, you know, is going to show some pretty hefty tumbling skills in the routine too. You just want to get it going. She did a little warm up on the side where she's ready to go, and now we're, you know, standing, waiting.
Went over, got a little more rosin on both her feet and her hands. Kaya Pratt, a score of 8.3, and here's Kay Murphy.
Beautiful start to a straddle split mount, which is a nice show of the flexibility. She does a back shoulder roll. And I believe we're going to do aerial walkover, land. Do you see how she kept her body moving? Hang on. Oh, darn, that was so close. It was a beautiful combination. She has great extension in her leaps. She's in a full split.
Grace Trainer of Wayzata had the high score in this event tonight with a 9.425. It will be the only score in the nines this evening.
Which, if she could, without the fall, I think she could have easily been up in the
nines.
Yep. Yep. Oh, that's really cute, though. Gosh darn, missed that one. Here she goes, aerial walkover, and her arms keep moving. She goes right into that back handspring, and just, you see that shoulder, and she is fighting like no tomorrow to try to stay on. This is just beautiful. She has back handspring step up, full twisting back layout, small step on the landing. Gets a congratulation from her coach there.
We'll hold on for a moment for Kay's score. Excuse me, Deb.
Oh, no, I was just going to say we were got a chance to look at a little bit of the Wyzetta Junior Varsity over there on the floor. Now, in between the events, which we usually don't get to see on camera because we're on a break, is when you get to see the teams get to warm up before each event. There's probably like a 3-minute warm-up prior to the teams having to compete on each event, so it's, which works well for those girls that maybe are only doing one event in an evening, and you know, they warm up for about, I would say, a good hour and a half prior to the meet even starting. When you're coming to a gym and you're not working on the equipment that you're used to, even though the majority of the equipment is made by the same company, the feel is different, the placement is different, the tension is a little bit different. So there's all kind of factors that play into. So you get that warm-up time before the meet starts.
Well, even with the fall, still a very good score for Kay Murphy, 9.05.
She would have been probably in the 9.5-9.6 range.
So nicely done for the Hopkins freshmen. We'll take a break and we'll come back. Wyzetta Varsity up on the floor. We wrap up our meet from Wyzetta High School. Our final rotation after this.
When I was in foster care, I never knew when I would have to move. So I always had my suitcase ready to go. Then one day I was adopted. My new parents opened their hearts and home to me. My parents cook my favorite breakfast for me every morning. My parents take me on trips I never thought I would go on. They gave me a home and an even better reason to use that suitcase. My parents aren't perfect, but they're perfect for me.
Our eighth and final rotation tonight, the Wyzetta Varsity up on the floor exercise. Tatum Bolson will be first, followed by Lauren Osterberg, Madeline Tapper, Izzy Trainer, and Grace Trainer.
She's probably very excited to be starting on the floor versus the balance beam. That's where she had that nasty, nasty fall. Watching her in warm-up, she seems like she's got a big smile. She's ready to go. Doing a twisting jump combination, connection into the corner for a first tumbling pass. Round up back handspring layout, half twist. Switch leap into full twisting tuck jump. Punch front, solid on that landing. Just like on the balance beam, there has to be a full turn on this as well. Setting up her final tumbling pass. Round up back handspring layout. What a nice way to end the meet after that fall on the balance beam. She came back strong. She did put up a pretty decent score here. So here she does that round up back handspring, and the body position is really great in that. It's completely laid out. There's no bend in the hip. She does that half twist and into a nice landing. This is a double punch front. Not even a wobble. And she ends with a nice back layout.
Osterberg is awaiting her spot. A score of 8.65 for Tatum Bolson. That's a high score for her for the season.
That was a nice start for Wisetta on the floor here. She opens up. She's a very powerful tumbler. Round up into that full twist. Switch leap, full twisting tuck jump. Strong routine for her.
Well, let's look at part of Lauren's routine again. Adam and Tapper will be up next. Here's going to look at it again.
And she starts out with that roundout full twist. Good body position on that. There's her two punch front. She's just so powerful. Bang, bang. And they're almost done in the laid out position. And then the final one is round up back handspring layout. And again, just a nice straight body, no bend in the hips. Good landing on that. It's a very noisy competition tonight.
A lot of enthusiasm in the gym. 8.35 the score for Lauren Osterberg. And now Madeline Tapper. Again, the only senior in this Wisetta team.
Wow.
Top all-around score this year has been 35.3, or top floor score, 8.975.
Beautiful punch front, punch front. What makes her fun to watch, too, is just the height that she gets on everything, from her tumbling passes to her leaps to her jumps. Oh gosh, round of back handspring, half twist. Unfortunately, she was just a low on that landing. Had a fall there. wonder if she knows that the team behind her is doing her whole floor routine with her. Third and final tumbling pass. Round off two backhand springs into a beautiful layout.
Madeline Tapper.
Nice floor routine, just that unfortunate fall that she had. She just didn't quite get her half twist all the way around to get her feet underneath her, which she wasn't able to complete the rotation. This was a great pass. Oops, sorry, that was the same one. I thought that was gonna be her last laid out pass. Just like on the balance beam, if you fall on the floor and you have a Here we go. This was her last tumbling pass. Just great. Round up two back handsprings layout. She kind of floats into the landing there. But when you fall on the floor, just like on the balance beam, that is a 5/10 deduction. And you can, if you put a hand down, it's a couple of tens. But when you actually, we call it sitting down, the trick actually where her seat hits the ground, that's a little bit more of a deduction on that. But a very pretty routine.
And it scores her an 8.50. Izzy Trainer up next.
She's a very strong tumbler, also when we watched her in warm-ups. Heads to the corner for that first pass. Round up 1.5 to full twist. Beautiful twisting split leap. Nice show of change of direction and some flexibility. Spring layout front for the second pass. Heads to the corner for that third pass. Round up back handspring full twist. Probably one of my favorite moves all time. It's called a Shishinova. It looks like it hurts, but it really doesn't. And she did it beautifully. You watch the Trainer sisters, and they don't really have a weak event. They're strong on all of them. I know we didn't get to see Grace tonight on the vault, but they both are solid all-around performers. So here she's gonna open up with, or her second pass here was a handspring layout front, which straight body, nice landing, and she ends with what a lot of girls tend to open with. She does round up back handspring full twist. So her first tumbling pass had a 1.5 twist. Her second tumbling pass, or her last tumbling pass, has a full twist. This should score very nicely.
Her sister Grace will be the final varsity competitor of the evening. Score 9.125 for Izzy.
I just wanted to say we're seeing the Wayzata girls sporting the teal ribbons now, so you've seen that both of the teams, and it just makes you really proud of the sport.
Grace Trainer, top scorer this year, this event, 9.75.
That is a huge score on the Florax. See what she opens up with. Beautiful round up, 1.5 twist right into the punch front. Switch leap into a twisting switch leap. Nice combination, good connection. Back handspring double twist for her second pass. I can see why she got a 9.7. This is beautiful. Kind of curious what she's going to throw for her last pass. Handspring layout punch front with a full twist. She gave us twisting in all three of her tumbling passes. You don't see that very often in high school. Really, really awesome routine.
Great way to finish off the meet. Grace Trainer, outstanding.
I mean, you've seen girls open with a twisting and closing, but she has twisting in all three. So here's that first one, 1.5 punch front. And she's like standing, she just stands up and nope, let's just throw a punch front. And this one, she does round up. Here's a double twist. A lot of times, that is difficult, and that's an opening pass. And full twisting layout front in her third pass. Okay, I'm hoping for 9.6, 9.7. Yeah. You know, 9.8 would even be fun. Not a lot of deductions.
And if she stays healthy, a state tournament bid, state meet bid, very likely again for a third year in a row for Grace. Well, I see one judge post a score of a 9.6. 9.6 from both judges. 9.60
nice.
For Grace Trainer.
Nice routine.
Great score.
Beautiful.
We'll take our final timeout. We'll tally the team scores, and we will finish our coverage of tonight's meet from Wayzata High School on CCX. After this timeout.
When I was in foster care, I never knew when I would have to move. So I always had my suitcase ready to go. Then one day, I was adopted. My new parents opened their hearts and home to me. My parents cook my favorite breakfast for me every morning. My parents take me on trips I never thought I would go on. They gave me a home and an even better reason to use that suitcase. My parents aren't perfect, but they're perfect for me.
There's our final team score tonight. Wayzata 139.45 to 134.85 for the Hopkins Royals. Welcome back to Wayzata. John Jacobson along with Debbie Rasmussen. And maybe those scores not out of line for what each of these teams has done this season. I think as we looked at the balance beam and thought, well, if he had just a few fewer falls and each team had several of them, those scores obviously be bumped up into the 140s for Wayzata and into the higher 130s for Hopkins.
You know, we talk a lot about how the balance beam can make or break a meet. And in this case, both teams struggled, so you can't, you know, say one team had a better night than the other. But, you know, here we are. There's still really good team scores. There's room for improvement. The coaches know that. We need to get back to being really consistent on that balance beam. What we did see tonight was some amazing scores, high scores, for both of the top all-rounders on each team. I think Gracie is going to be someone to be a big force in the state meet with her big, huge scores that she had. And we didn't even get to see her on vault tonight. So I think she's going to be a really tough all-around competitor when it comes to that section meet.
And again, a change this year in section meets for all the sections in the state in that there are just three all-arounders from each section that qualify for state. But in each of the four apparatus, three additional girls in addition to the all-arounders can qualify for state. So more opportunities for more girls to get to state. So some of these girls tonight that perhaps wouldn't have been state qualifiers in the past certainly could be this year when their section meets come up in 3 weeks.
It just opens the door for girls that maybe specialize in one or two events that aren't competing in that all-around competition to have that chance, because your all-rounder is going to be strong on all four events, but your specialist is going to come up with those big scores. And you look at the way the Olympics had done it, they had girls that only competed on bars or only competed on balance beam, but they were able to medal in those events. So I think this just opens the door up for more competitors in the state meet. Very excited about this new change.
And a reminder that both these teams will compete in section meets in mid-February. Wayzata part of Section 5AA. That's February 15th, a Thursday night at Irondale High School. Hopkins will be at Minnetonka for the Section 6AA meet on Saturday the 17th of February, and then the state meet at the University of Minnesota the following week. And that will do it for our telecast tonight. Thanks to Deb Rasmussen and all of our great crew here tonight. I'm John Jacobson. Thanks so much for tuning in for our coverage tonight of this late conference meet. Wayzata winning tonight over Hopkins. And good night from Wayzata High School.